Nathan, you will not believe how many electric concept vehicles Toyota just dropped on us.
And you know, some of these things look a little bit more production ready than others, and they all look really cool.
Yeah, so in this video, we're going to show you everything we know so far from this huge unveiling that Toyota just did. And they dropped on us an electric pickup.
Yeah.
An electric, what looks like FJ Cruiser.
Little FJ, yeah.
You can kind of see a little preview of this.
Yeah, we'll hit some bigger pictures in a minute.
Yes, and also 15 other vehicles.
Yeah, that's right, including a really cool looking sports car.
Yes, so let's get going because, you know, Akio Toyoda, the CEO of the global Toyota company, yeah. He introduced us. They had like an hour and a half long debut.
Yeah, and we saw some of that, and it was a little bit difficult to watch the whole thing, especially because we know for a fact that Mr. Toyota does not really want to be in the electric age. He's thrilled with hybrids. He's not so thrilled with the EVs.
Yes, and coincidentally, all of these are BEV, so battery electric vehicle. And some of them have the BZ name, like this BZ compact SUV.
What does BZ mean?
It means beyond zero.
Oh.
So here's my take on Toyota's strategy, right? Okay. So Toyota... Well, obviously, they've said they're not going all electric.
Right.
Some other companies, like some luxury brands, like
General
Volvo,
Motors even
General Motors, said we're going all electric by 2030.
Right.
Toyota has always said, and I was there at their headquarters a few months ago, mm-hmm. they said there will always be a combination of gas-powered, hybrid-powered, maybe even hydrogen vehicles, right? Battery electric vehicles. So they see it as a kind of a combination of all kinds of vehicles.
Yeah, indeed. But I think what they're doing with this huge debut is they're showing that they're serious about electric vehicles. For a while, we thought that they were just kind of throwing things out there just for the press to eat up. But some of these vehicles really do look like they're pretty close to production. And one thing, unfortunately, we did not get were specifications on what type of battery, lithium ion, solid state, we don't know, propulsion systems, any of that actually, we don't have any of that, but we do have some very interesting images of vehicles that could hint to future vehicles.
Yeah, this they call the BZ Large SUV, mm-hmm. very simple name for the concept, but this almost looks like a Highlander sized vehicle.
It does, doesn't it? It looks about the same. I would say the wheelbase is about the same, that's for sure.
Yeah, and so we know what their electric strategy kind of is because the BZ4X is already a production car that's been unveiled.
Right.
And BZ4X, which is kind of similar in size to this SDN, which is a sedan.
Yeah. Yeah. Good job, Andre.
I can decipher. The BZ4X has about 72 kilowatt hour battery,
right.
Approximately 250 mile range,
right.
And approximately 200 plus horsepower. So Toyota, I think, is a little bit conservative here, like usual, right, for them, because reliability, dependability are high on their priority list. And, you know, 800 horsepower cars are a little bit lower on their priority list.
Right. And the thing is, most of us out there are not able to afford these super expensive electric vehicles, which has always been my point of view. That's why I can't stand these high-priced ones. However, I think that Toyota's trying to say, I think we can build these economical ones. Ooh.
Economical ones.
Yeah, look at what you did there.
But this one. So
two of them are very, very interesting.
Yeah, so first of all, you have a sneak peek of the electric pickup, like we promised. Mm-hmm. And this they call the Compact Cruiser EV. So they're not using the FJ name played behind this.
Right.
And this is also compact. So if you think this is approximately a mid-size pickup truck size,
right,
this is, looks a little bit smaller to me.
Yeah, you know what it looks like? It looks like it's in between the size of, say, a Ford Bronco Sport and maybe a Jeep Renegade. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and it has that traditional look. I mean, Toyota script on the grill, right?
Yeah.
And recalls FJ's like 40s from the past, but also the FJ Cruiser.
Right, look at the door design. You can really see some of that there. And the high plastics.
Yeah.
Fairly good looking ground clearance. I'd say that looks like it's between 9 and 10 inches of ground clearance and probably a flat belly. We have no idea what these things can do, if they can do anything. However, this one, honestly, if they were to sell this, right, and they were able to sell it for a reasonable price with a decent amount of range, not an extraordinary amount of range, it would sell like hotcakes. I think people would love to get an all-wheel drive vehicle like
well,
this.
Well, I'm just pleasantly relieved, you know, seeing this concept because, you know, some visions of the future are just like blobs, you know,
yeah.
These capsules that are autonomous driving. you know, in the big city. But this is not a blob or a capsule. This looks like a retro design coming into the future. And look, all of them have or show seats and also forward-facing seats.
And mirrors.
And maybe even, and mirrors and maybe even steering wheels.
Right, not a yoke. But also, look, tow hooks. Tommy would be thrilled.
Red.
Oh, boy. So that's a little off-roady thing, but let's go to the...
next one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Here we are. We're going to get to the pickup truck in a second, I promise. So another crossover, you know, they unveiled, and this is global of unveiling for them. So not all these vehicles will come to the U.S., obviously.
Right. We expect to see the crossovers most likely if they actually happen.
And pickups, of course. Yeah.
Right. But some of the other ones, maybe not.
Will this come to the U.S.?
Well, technically, maybe. So they were going to test this vehicle. It's going to be at the Olympics. This e-Palette essentially is a people mover, semi-autonomous, I believe. And it's one of those that is built for walking into. That's why it's so tall.
Yeah.
And you sit comfortably like a tiny mini bus, and it just takes you casually to where you need to go.
No, you know what this looks like to me?
What?
Well, the name, e-Palette. It looks like they stack people in there.
Well, that's one way
is to, it supposed to be for people, or is it supposed to be for packages?
Andre, that's very deep.
Well, that's the e-Palette, I think, in the background.
Look what else they have.
They have the mid-box, they have the micro-box, which is their utility van.
I think they're kind of cool, actually.
Yeah, that's really cool. They also have the sports car we'll show you in a second.
Yep.
Lexus unveiled several vehicles, too. And look at this. I want to actually zoom in on this.
Yes, please.
If you can. So this actually could be a preview of the next Tacoma, because we know what the next Tundra is already on sale.
Mm-hmm.
But look at the rear taillights on this smaller pickup. Looks Tundra-esque.
Yeah, look at the roof design, and then look at the front end design and the way that looks, and combine everything together, including the fender design. Mm-hmm. That very well could be a very similar shape to what the next Tacoma is going to look like, even though they're saying this is an electric pickup.
Yes, but this may be still a design preview, not just technology preview, right? So I'm very excited by this. Let's take a closer look.
I think that's cool looking.
Dude, this is the micro box.
Yeah, you should get one of those and get ready for your i3. Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
there's another view of the micro box and the bigger box.
I believe the micro box looks like it can hold up to four people fairly comfortably, but it's not really a cargo thing per se. Whereas in the mid box, whatever they call it, looks a little bit more cargo-ish.
Yes, it does. And that makes sense for deliveries, right? Mm-hmm. So that makes a lot of sense.
That's kind of cool, I think. There it is.
Yeah.
So very Tacoma-like in the front end, right?
Mm-hmm.
Except for this, obviously that grill means electric. It has to, because that's why they put it there. Andre and I were speculating whether or not it actually has an electric powertrain. But if you look at the hood design, and if you look at just how the vehicle stands, it does look like it could be the next Tacoma.
Yeah, and also big, large tires. They look like KO2s from BF Goodrich.
Those look like 35s, dude.
They could be. They could be approaching that. Huge approach angle, really good ground clearance. This could be over 11 inches of ground clearance or more.
Yeah.
So I think what they're saying is, And also, I'm a little bit surprised, because I kind of expected the Tundra to be electric.
Yeah.
But this appears to be something smaller than the Tundra. And it has a lot of Tacoma vibes, definitely.
It does. Obviously, Hilux vibes as well. But we're expecting that the Tacoma and the Hilux will run on a very similar platform and possibly some similar powertrains. Who knows? Maybe electric.
Yeah, so we know for 2023, some prototypes are already out there for the next generation Tacoma.
Right.
They're going to be sharing their chassis with TNGA-F, mm-hmm. With the Tundra. And when I pressed Toyota engineers during the Tundra unveiling, and I said, what other powertrains will you have?
Mm-hmm.
They couldn't talk about it, but they said multiple types of powertrains could be able to fit inside of this chassis.
Ooh.
Yeah, so they're not throwing away their frames, right? They're reusing a lot of that technology.
Which, once again, takes a little bit of a page out of Ford's playbook. So I'm curious to whether or not they're benchmarking Ford once again.
But who knows? Will it have independent rear suspension?
Good.
Will it have, you know, two motors, three motors, four motors, low power, high power, range?
Yeah, obviously we do not know that yet, but it's a nice little sneak peek, and I'm sure you guys are kind of like going, this could be interesting. Let's move on.
Yeah, but it looks very, very traditional.
That view really shows me that it has a lot of Tundra in it. Look at the shape of the fender in the back, the way they box it off. It's very similar to the larger Tundra, very similar up front as well. and the hood design. So there's a lot of Tundra goodness in there. It looks better than the Tundra in my book because the grill's not ridiculous, but we'll see. It's interesting. I really, really am curious.
But this looks also realistic. You know how Nissan unveiled several concepts recently?
Yeah, where you could see through them and all that.
Yeah, you could see through it. There is no bulkhead between the bed and, right. and the cabin. But that looked really futuristic out there.
Right.
This looks like they could build it within a couple of years, 2, 3, 4 years, maybe.
Maybe. A lot of speculation. You can see the little guy right there.
A little
there.
Cruiser poking out.
Yeah. That little cruiser is very interesting. It really does look like it's something that's ready for production, doesn't it?
Yes.
And
then this. I think all of us have been wanting a sports car that's electric, right?
A real one.
A real one, yes. And maybe even kind of affordable. So... they also showed...
Now, there's been a rumor for a while that they wanted to start a new MR2 project where it was a majority rear/mid-engine small sports car. This looks like it's very small, and it's got the Gazoo Racing right there on the front. So there's every indication that this thing could be ridiculously quick and fun. I have no idea what the specs are on it, but it was built for old man Toyota.
And I think also, I hope it's affordable, right? Maybe in the Supra range right now, like 50 to 60 grand or lower, that would be sweet.
I mean, it would be sweet, but we just don't know.
So I think this is kind of the most significant, at least for us in the US.
Right.
The truck, looking forward to this. I think, Ford F-150 Lightning is coming next year.
Yep.
The Hummer EV, the Rivian. This could be close in size to the Rivian in many respects.
Yeah, and also I would say the Tesla, but the Tesla's gonna be a lot wider.
All right, guys, well, there you have it. This is all the news. We kind of showed you a lot.
Yeah.
We don't have a lot of numbers, unfortunately, because Toyota did not provide it.
We have no numbers, actually.
Oh, no numbers.
And also, I know there are some other vehicles that were up there on the screen, but they were kind of basic and simple compared to these other ones that kind of grabbed our attention. And if you guys have any insight in terms of what we're looking at, or if you have some information, let us know in the comments below.
Yep. And tfl-studios.com is where you'll see all this coverage, because the cruiser is going to be on off-road, our off-road website, TFL
right.
Off-road, truck on TFL truck, TFL car. There are no motorcycles, so unfortunately we'll have to wait for that.
Toyota doesn't really do motorcycles very often. So,
there you go.
Yeah, there you are.
So thanks for joining us.
See you guys.